Hi artists, if you're building your website for the first time, you want to keep in mind some SEO search engine optimization tips. So here's some basic things you should keep in mind. Not going to dive too deep. I do have a full SEO guide that you can purchase linked in the description of this video if you want to go really deep into this. But as you're creating the first website, just keep these things in mind. First of all, longevity is the whole point of SEO. So go ahead and start your website as soon as possible. Longevity really works in your favor as far as contextualizing you and making sure you exist within the greater scheme of the internet. The longer your website is available, the more authority you'll have and the better context you'll have within search engine algorithms. The first thing that's important is having 150 to 250 words of text per page, if not more. So this is a galleries page from my old website. I have three main galleries, and the whole point of this page is to get people to see pictures of my work, but I made sure to have this description here. You can put it below the gallery if you want. It doesn't have to be at the top. And then I made descriptions here that have keywords in them as well. The search engines have a much harder time scanning through photos and determining what they're about and where they should categorize them, but they don't have as hard a time with text. So you want to make sure you have at least 150 to 250 words of text, even if it's a picture heavy page. And I mentioned keywords, so that's really important too, to have a basic understanding of keywords. You can search these at Moz Keyword Explorer. That's my favorite one. You can create an account and do, I think it's like 10 searches a month or something like that. So anything that you want to talk about, if you are a wedding planner in Omaha, for what, for instance, then you could search like wedding planner Omaha. Oh my God, you guys. Wedding planner in Omaha. Yes, you have 10 queries available. And it'll tell you related stuff. It'll tell you who's at the top for those. It'll tell you how many people are searching those things and give you ideas of other keywords that you can use. So use up those 10 queries. Take advantage of that free work. You can pay for a membership too. But keep in mind, you want to use words that people are actually searching. So no one is searching, like I make imitation suites, but that's not a very common word. So we see about 480 people a month are searching for that. Whereas if I do imitation cards, I'm predicting about 165,000 people are searching that. Wouldn't I rather get found on something like that? So when you're using cutesy words or industry sayings, those aren't gonna get as much search traffic. So you wanna try to alter your text so that it's more in line with what people are actually searching. This right here, I'm using a tool called Keywords Everywhere that you do have to pay for, but it's not very much money. And then it just will show me search results on YouTube or Yahoo or Google or anywhere that you search, it'll give you search results. A lot of people think that you have to start a blog, but you don't necessarily have to do that. All of the platforms that are really common that we mentioned, Squarespace, Wix, Show It, WordPress, all of these include a blog capability. So if you want to add it later, you can. The best thing I can tell you about blogs is to focus on your ideal client finding you. Don't focus on the audience you already have, because those people already like you and know you, and they will be served equally by stuff that serves a new audience. So try and optimize your blog posts for keywords that are gonna get you organic traffic. Otherwise, you're just spending a lot of time writing stuff for people who already follow you and like you. Two more things that you should really keep in mind when it comes to SEO are how you name your images and how you name all of your navigation and headings. So our navigation is home, about, shop, work, supplies, contact. These are all very, very simple things that people understand. When I click on this, I know exactly what I'm getting: work, gallery, services, FAQ, that kind of thing. But if you use something, again, like if your collection has a really fun name in French that means something really cool and sophisticated, they're not gonna click on that because they don't know what that is. They're looking for contact. They're not looking for say hi necessarily, even though mine does say hi after you click contact. All of the navigation is going to be really pivotal into how the search engine optimizes your traffic and show your traffic and search results. So you wanna make sure you keep these really simple so that people can understand what they're doing, and it will help with the flow of your website as well. In the same vein, you want to use your headings correctly. So in this blog post, the title is what should go on your invitation map. That's an H1 text. So that means that it's a little bit bigger. It's telling the search engines by putting it at H1 that it is the main title of this page. And then anything that is below that, like a paragraph heading, what is an imitation map or what goes on an imitation map, these are the headings that the search engines are going to see as topics within that H1 topic. So these are H2, heading 2, or H3, there's all kinds. And then there's paragraph text, which is your main text. So it's going to look at those different ways. And also, if you're writing a blog post or a long article, these will help with accessibility. So if someone is vision impaired, the readers will use these to help them like skip to the paragraphs that are convenient to them. So it helps with accessibility and it helps with SEO. And then when you save your images, let's see what happens if I did it with this one or not. Yes, yeah, so this one, you want the image name to be like Rosemary Beach Wedding Imitation Map. So when you upload an image to Squarespace, which is the platform that I'm in right now, it allows you to change the image title. And you don't want to just keyword stuff that with a million things. You want it to be really relevant so that if someone does search Rosemary Beach Wedding Imitation Map, it's likely that this image is going to come up, even though that is more specific than this whole blog post and what that's talking about. It will show up on those specific searches, which is really great because I want people who want a Rosemary Beach map to contact me since I've already done that work and it will be a little bit of an easier project. So just to recap, when you are doing SEO for your first website, you want to pay attention to getting it out there. Just get it done. Don't let perfection like freeze frame you from not creating your website because you want longevity. Put 150 to 250 words per page using keywords that you search from like Moz Keyword Explorer, not using cutesy sayings. Using the H1, H2 headings to delineate like what's important on the page and what's not important on the page. And within your navigation, make sure those are really easy to determine topics. And then also when you upload images, making sure the file names and the captions are something that's relevant that could be searchable for that photo. If you liked the skills learned in this video, make sure you join our monthly membership, Stationery School, to get 2 20-minute courses and more every single month. If you're not quite there yet, I also run a private stationery community on Facebook that's free to join. Find the Stationery Squad link in the description of this video.